much open space as we actually did. There's another, was another little thing that I enjoyed very much, and that would be occasionally you'd be sitting in your office and some person would come to the door and they'd kind of like, you know, be standing there like this, and you'd say, come on in. Well, I didn't want to bother you. I said, come in. What do you need? And they would be having trouble understanding something about their tax bill, and helping them out, having them sit down, helping them out, and seeing them go away happy was an important part of the job. Those two things. Oh, I should say to you, I never had a big challenge because I was so adept at handling everything that came my way. That's not true. The truth is that every once in a while some crazy would come in and you just didn't understand what they wanted. I think that the hardest part of the job was the long hours that you put into it at night meetings and that sort of thing. You're never home at night, and it could get pretty trying at times. My dad had interested in me in being a lawyer, and I spent a lot of time thinking about it. I wasn't particularly good at math or anything else, so I knew I wasn't going to be a scientist of any kind. And I liked working with people, dealing with people. Because it was my hometown and nobody had ever done it, I wanted to be the first who did it, and I thought I could make a decent living at it in Weston, and it would give me time to be involved in government and politics. Probably when I was 10 years old, my two uncles had been first selectmen, and it was dinner table conversation, politics and government, and it sounded very interesting, and I just wanted to get involved. I built 2,000 feet of stone wall around my house.
That's right. That's right.
I enjoyed building stone walls. My wife hated it, but I enjoyed it. Can't always drag my wife to them with me, but I've been to see, I think, the homesteads of something like 9 or 10 presidents of the United States. Enjoy that. And anything like that. I loved working on the old historic home that I had. Did a lot of that work myself. That's the kind of thing that I enjoyed. I don't think I'm going to tell you. I always wanted a Corvette. I actually had two of them. I loved Corvettes. You may say that I have a Corvette mentality. I do. I couldn't have one when I was in high school, so I got one later on when I made some money. My mother, without a doubt. After my dad died, my mother, she's always full of words of encouragement. My father. He was killed by a drunk driver when I was 13, and I got to know my mother. My mother lived until I was about 35 years old, so I knew my mother well, and my kids got to know my mother very well, and they still talk about her. My kids never did get to meet my dad, and when I did that interview for the Newtown newspaper, I couldn't hold it together. Mm. Yeah. It's you would think at my age you'd get over this, but I never did. That's very interesting. Probably an actor. Although a lot of people say that I was an actor. Not a lot. I mean, it was always the same form of government. And we were always blessed with people who wanted to work hard for the town. Town meeting was starting to be a waste of time. because the town was getting, once a town gets to a certain population, it loses, a town meeting just doesn't work. But other than that, I don't think it changed very much at all. You've got to volunteer. I mean, you have to. That's an obligation that all Americans have, is to volunteer their time and effort. And people immediately write it off because they say, yeah. Oh, I don't want to be a politician. You know what? Until you get involved with it, you don't know how many really good, dedicated people you're going to meet.